Oh, what do we got here? Moloch charger for $12. I'll take that. Don't need that. Cage for $12. These are all troll stuff. Oh, Megatron. How much is Megatron? $20? I don't know if I want to pay that much for that. And he's $7. What the crap?
Yeah.
He's bigger. How come he's cheaper? Superman. The hell are those? Ooh, more Transformers. Wait, why is this Transformer $12 and Megatron was $20? That doesn't make any sense. They're not in good shape though. All those boxes are trashed. I don't like those boxes. Oh, Squirrel Girl. Squirrel Girl's $14. That's pretty neat. What's this one over here? What the hell?
Give me a roll of tape.
Just buy a roll of tape, yeah. It's like that beer pong game. You can just get your own cups. You don't need to buy it. Check the regular aisle now.
So now let's check out the loot. Hey.
So yeah, thanks a lot for watching my little quick trip to Ollie's. And let's check out some of the stuff I picked up. Plus I stopped at a little sort of like vintage thrift shop kind of thing and found a few items that we'll take a look at here as well. I didn't get any footage inside that store because they just had sporadic things randomly thrown about, so it was kind of not really cohesive, and I didn't think it was that exciting. So All right, let's take a look at what I got at Ollie's. So at Ollie's, I picked up the Jar Jar Binks. Had to get that. Such a good price. And I just figured, why not have another one? I can keep him in the box, and because I've got him open already. And just have him as an extra. You never know what'll be needed down the road, if they're a trade or whatever. And I picked up the Princess Leia with Wicket the Ewok from Force of Destiny. I never got this one, and since I saw it for cheap, I figured, why not grab it? Why not? And then picked up the two packs from the Solo movie. I never had this one. I didn't get it when it first came out. I wasn't too fond of these two action figures, just Luke and or Han and Chewie, covered in mud. So I didn't buy them when they were at retail. But what was that, $3 or $4? I had to get it, you know, for that price and add that to the collection. And then I grabbed these. I've got a lot of these because I've been troop building this guy, the Kessel Guard. So I got another one to keep troop building that guy. And I've been getting these dogs. I've been wanting more of these dogs. I've already got like two of these, I think, open. So I wanted to grab another one to open and have more of these guys. Because again, you can troop build these guys, and I think they look pretty cool. Same with that Kessel Guard. I mean, like, he just looks awesome. And he looks really great out of the packaging. His staff can click into his back, and he can hang onto it with one hand or two. So he really works out well as a troop builder guy, because you can put him in different... Even as a 5POA, you can sort of do him in different styles, in a sense, to make it look like there's an army of them. And I think he's a pretty cool guy. I think I've already got three open. This will make number four, I think. So really building that army up. And let's see. So that was it from Ollie's that I grabbed. And then the little sort of thrifty shop I went to, I found these guys. I got the this band member Rodian guy. And he has a flute. This neat flute. Although it doesn't stay in his hands that well, but at least it was there. And then I got this guy because I was really interested that I got to compare it, but this looks almost the same as the Kenner one. And the dude still has plastic on him, like he's brand new. Max Rebo there. So, yeah, I just thought it looked great. I was like, he almost looks like the Kenner one. So I just thought that was cool. I had to have him. For Star Wars, I got this Bendem of Bib Fortuna. Now, I have never, ever seen these in the wild, actually. You know, I know other people who own these guys, but I've never seen them myself in a store for sale. Like, this last run, I think, had the Gamorrean Guard, because I've never had him. Emperor's Royal Guard, maybe even the Emperor himself, and this General Lando. Like, I never saw them. I might not have even seen that Luke X-Wing. I never saw them in the wild, never was able to get them. And I know that they exist. I know people who own them. You know, I've seen them in people's personal collections, but I just never saw them in stores or in the wild until I found this guy. And so I had to grab him. I was just, it's just kind of neat. It's one of those things of history. And he was like $5. It's like, why not? And then I got this Super Friends pencil sharpener. Just cause. I mean, it's a little pencil sharpener parts right there. And it's got cool packaging, and it's from 1980. So I was just like, I love vintage weird things like this, and so I just had to get it. I can't believe that if that was the price in 1980, this was freaking expensive. Yeah, it's crazy. And then this Knight Rider rub and play transfer sheet from Colorforms, and it's from 1982. But I just love old things like this. It's just so cool. Very, very neat. And again, this was like $5, and so I was just blown away by it, you know. I just like that it's like Knight Rider and stuff, something we watched as a kid like over and over again. And yeah, they said it was new old stock, like they got a box of these, and so I might go back and get a couple more for some friends. I know a couple people that might want that. Now that I've shown it off to a few people, I do know that a couple people are interested, and they're not that expensive, so I could pick up a couple more for friends. All right, I think that's going to be about it for this quick little video. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I'm John. I'm out of here, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one. See ya.